just knock, okay?
Hi.
Hi. Robin, I've sort of said this already. I mean, I've half said it. I've tried to say it, and I've said it badly. So this is me, just saying it, with strings. I'm crazy about you. I think we should be together. What do you say?
Kids, as you know, Christmas is a time you spend with your family. So in December of 2006, I had three options. Spend it with my mom and her new boyfriend, Clint. Spend it with my dad and his new girlfriend, Microbrewing. Or head down to Staten Island to spend it with my super religious cousin, Stacy, and her family. So I opted for none of the above and decided to spend Christmas 2006 in Manhattan. Celebrating with my other family.
Okay.
Marshall's breakup with Lily had sent him into a deep depression and nothing could get him out of it. Until one day...
She was perfect.
Who is it?
Pizza delivery.
Whoa.
Hey, you tricked me.
You really thought I was the pizza delivery guy?
No, I knew it was you. Just thought you'd at least bring a pizza.
Yeah, well, I brought a beer, but I gave it to a homeless guy. Already took it from me.
Holy crap, the magical Christmas season is upon us. And thank God we don't pay for utilities.
Merry Christmas.
What's in the box?
Only the best present for the best girl ever. Took me all day to track it down.
No. I need that package today.
Listen, the truck already left 5 minutes ago, so unless you want to run after it...
Stop! Stop! Stop, please, stop! Stop the truck! I need a package on your truck. Can I please take a look in back?
Sure, but I gotta keep driving my route. I'm running behind.
My man! I'm okay!
Merry Christmas, Marshall. Where are Marshall and Lily?
They just called. They're both super swamped preparing for tomorrow. It is just a burger.
Just a burger? Just a burger. Robin. It's so much more than just a burger. I mean, that first bite. Oh, what heaven that first bite is. The bun, like a sesame freckled breast of an angel resting gently on the ketchup and mustard below, flavors mingling in a seductive pas de deux. And then, a pickle. The most playful little pickle. And then a slice of tomato, a leaf of lettuce, and a patty of ground beef. So exquisite. Swirling in your mouth, breaking apart and combining again in a fugue of sweets and savory. So delightful. This is no mere sandwich of grilled meat and toasted bread, Robin. This is God speaking to us through food.
And you got our wedding vows off the internet.
The laundry room?
I require a laundry room of 15 feet by 15 feet. Stain-proof ceramic tile from floor to ceiling. I'm a man who likes to do his own laundry, and sometimes it gets messy.
Messy?
Messy.
Steel chains will dangle from the ceiling at a height of 9 feet. And that is where my laundry bags will hang for 3 days and three nights before I clean them.
Ted, it kind of sounds like what this guy is asking you to design.
It's a murder house.
It is. It's totally a murder house.
I will be performing the He's Not Coming. Glad you asked.
To perform the He's Not Coming, here's what you'll need. The observation deck of the Empire State Building. Are you up there? Good. For generations, this has been the spot New Yorkers have chosen for their romantic reunions with long-estranged lovers. So all you have to do is walk up to every girl you see and say, "He's not coming."
What are you talking about?
Never mind. He's not coming. He's not coming. She's not coming? Sorry. Until sooner or later, he's not coming.
I'm sorry I hit you, buddy. I wanted to make it up to you by giving you this.
Wow, she's hot.
Yeah. Well, someday you're gonna marry her.
No way.
Pretty lucky.
Totally. I'll be my tenth.
Oh, no. Wait, hey, no, you don't do that. Have fun for me.
No, he's not seeing anyone. Remember, he asked us to find it.
Oh, no.
Hey! Hey! What, are you married?
I don't know what kind of architect houses, buildings, that kind of crap.
Want to marry my friend Ted?
What? You can be choosy? You're in a bar on Valentine's Day, huh?
Hey, just real quick. You want to marry my friend, Ted?
Kids, in my early days of being a professor, I had one simple goal. Give a lecture that changes someone's life. Then one afternoon in 2010, I achieved that goal.
Unfinished. Of all the words you could use to describe La Sagrada Familia, brown, pointy, weird. The one that really seems to stick is unfinished. Why? Because on June 7th, 1926, the architect, Antoni Gaudi, whose beard was also brown, pointy, weird, and unfinished, was run over by a bus. And so, his greatest masterpiece would remain forever.
But first, let's back up a few days. So later that night, Barney and Nora went skating.
Hey, kid. You know how your mom won't let you have ice cream till after dinner? But then the waiting kind of makes it taste better? Well, I've been waiting 2 months for that bowl of ice cream. And tonight, I'm gonna have sex with it.
Look, Bonnie! 1 foot!
Now, kids, for most guys, this would have meant the end of the date. But your Uncle Barney is not most guys.
I can turn this around.
And that's what happened in the dining room. Now I'm gonna tell you what happened in the kitchen.
Oh no, that's not what you want.
Man, I can't believe these aren't vegan.
Back to our fight.
3 years from now, when we're watching the trilogy in 2006, our lives are gonna be awesome.
Oh, hello, Ted. I'm an environmental lawyer now. Sure, it's not the most lucrative field, but luckily I have the cash and prizes for my historic 7-week run on Wheel of Fortune.
Can I just make one little adjustment?
For which I was knighted by Her Majesty the Queen. Ah, Lady Aldrin.
Oh, Sir Marshal, I cannot wait to get a house down the street from your parents so we can be close to your mom, whom I get along with now.
But here's the best part.
I was painting the baby furniture.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Hurry up before Marshall gets home. Oh, yeah. Oh.
Sorry, baby, were you asleep?
You want to dance, Mosby? Let's talk about yesterday.
Hi! You guys, I'm so sorry. I'm so late. I'm going to run upstairs, change. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
Take your time, sweetie.
Yeah, this seems like a really bad idea.
I don't care. I am going into that bedroom because this is my home, and I have to defend it. But mostly because my allergy medication is in there!
Right, just be careful, okay? This girl is really crazy.
Yeah, well, why can't she just accept the fact that you guys broke up?
I know. I know, why can't she just accept that? Why? It's like, why?
It might be because we didn't actually break up.
Let me tell you about the thing you say is just pizza. We begin with the first bite.
Oh, the crunch. And then the marinara. That roiling lava of tomato and oregano that overtakes you. I'm falling.
And that's when she catches you. That chewy, voluptuous mistress.
Mozzarella.
Her oven-kissed cheeks crackle with warmth in your mouth, cradling the sauce and the bread, letting you know that from now on, this is home. This pizza is home.
If it was so delicious, why'd they close it in the first place?
Rats.
We're not stopping!
This road trip sucks!